The third form of evidence for evolution is called biogeography. Biogeography involves the study of the past and present distribution of organisms across the Earth's surface. So if we look at a map, we would expect to see similar species living in neighboring areas. And a good way to think about this is if we use examples of archipelagos of islands like Hawaii or the Galapagos. Here you have islands that have been formed about the same time. They're isolated from anywhere else on Earth. And we've already seen the Galapagos finches. There are other birds that live on the islands. Here's the Galapagos mockingbirds. They've all been given the same genus name, but they're four perfectly good species. They're rather similar to each other, and they're found in the Galapagos and nowhere else. So this gets back to Darwin's notion that, oh, the Galapagos finches must have had a single ancestor, came over, diversified while they were out there, and they're more similar to each other than they are to anything back in the mainland. That's likewise true with the Galapagos mockingbirds. Now, Hawaii is even more isolated from the rest of the world than the Galapagos, and it has rather extraordinary native species. Here's a whole group of birds called honeycreepers. They've shown extraordinary diversification here, some with huge, long, curved beaks, others with short, rather squat beaks, lots of different colors, and they're all more closely related to each other than they are to anything else. They diversified after one founding family got out there somehow and then left a variety of descendants. In Hawaii, we also have a number of different kinds of insects that are found there and nowhere else. So there's some really quite remarkable fruit flies. These are Drosophila. These are picture-wing Drosophila. And there's over a dozen different species of these that are found on the Hawaiian Islands, nowhere else. And these lines here actually indicate a history of how one lineage may have traveled from one island to the other, given rise to a new lineage. The point is that these all diversified there and nowhere else. We've already seen the concept of biogeography a bit when I talked about the Ratites. The Ratites was that monophyletic group of flightless birds that originated before the breakup of Gondwana. And so you had one ancestor that could travel freely back and forth, then the continent separated, and then diversification would happen within each continent. Okay? And that reflects the deep history and the old age of this particular group. So these birds have been around for a really long time, back when the continents were still connected. Now, biogeography also gives us an opportunity to really appreciate the power of convergent evolution. We looked at analogous traits like wings in bats and birds or streamlined shape in dolphins and penguins. And this is where a common problem is solved in the same way by different lineages. Even though they don't have a recent evolutionary history, selection has favored a certain response to a certain problem, like flight or being able to move quickly through the water. Now, Australia is an extraordinary continent. It's separated off quite some time ago, and so there's an early form of mammals that were really common in those days called marsupials. We'll see more about marsupials much later in the course. And those are the only mammals on Australia for all of its history until just recently when modern humans brought their pets to the continent of Australia. So you have this extraordinary lineage of marsupials that diversified to give us things like kangaroos and marsupial moles, Tasmanian tigers. These things look really, really different from each other, and some of them look really extraordinarily similar to different kinds of mammals that live in other continents. So the wolf is found in Asia, North America, Europe, and it's a carnivore that gives birth to quite large young. The Tasmanian tiger is a marsupial. It's like a kangaroo. It gives birth to a tiny little embryo that then crawls into the mother's pouch and completes its development there. But otherwise, the Tasmanian tiger looks an awful lot like a wolf. And that's because there's a certain way to run down prey and being able to grab it with a long snout so you can then catch it and eat it. There's one good way to be a mole. Even if you're a marsupial mole that, like a kangaroo, gives birth to a tiny little embryo which completes its development in the mother's pouch, as opposed to a normal mole that we have all over the rest of the world that gives birth to a much more developed offspring. But the shape is almost identical, even though they've had very different evolutionary histories for a very, very long period of time. These are wonderful examples of convergent evolution. So biogeography reveals a constant process of speciation and diversification of life on Earth.